Researchers typically agree that conformity is yielding to group pressures. According to Philip Zimbardo, whenever we change our behaviors, views, and attitudes in response to the real or imagined presence of others, we are experiencing conformity. This phenomenon occurs in two main forms, normative conformity and informational conformity. In his line judgment task, Solomon Ash demonstrated that the normative desire to be accepted propels social influence. Ash prompted participants to select lines matching in length and then share answers with one another. Although only one set of lines blatantly matched, participants were willing to change their answers in order to fit into the group and avoid ridicule. On the other hand, Stanley Milgram demonstrated that the actions of others may also serve as informational cues on how to behave, especially during ambiguous or uncertain situations. Milgram placed Confederates on a street corner and instructed them to gaze intently at the open sky. As the number of Confederates increased across trials, so too did the number of passing pedestrians who stopped and stared upwards at the sky. Our video demonstrates the power of informational conformity on student life at UNC. Dr. Baczynski emailed his Psych 222 students about holding extra office hours to review exams, but he was ambiguous about the time.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed.
Whew, I made it in time. Dr. B should still be holding his office hours. Here we are. Here's his office. Oh, boy. Well, I guess all these people are here to talk to Dr. B as well. I'll just take a seat with them. This room sure is crowded. No one's gone into or out of the office, even. Has anyone even knocked on the door? I bet no one's even knocked on the door. Well, everyone else doesn't seem too concerned. The group must know what they're doing. I'll just follow the group. He must be talking to someone who bombed the test worse than I did.
So,
are you guys here for Dr. B's office hours?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, I guess I'll keep waiting since everyone else is. Surely, these people know something I don't.
I guess no one wanted to review their exams. Oh, why are you guys just sitting here?
Well,
since the actions of other students served as social cues, the subject subscribed to informational conformity. He assumes that his peers are privy to information that he is unaware of and therefore matches his behavior to theirs.